Hello again, everyone. On our next trip, we're going to PACS from PAUT. And that is what I have here. Hang on a second while I take a quick look at what that is. Okay, we're at Akukan right now. That's what this is here. And now we're going to PACS. Let me see what airport is that. I should have checked this before I started, but since I didn't, here we go. PACS, and that is Cape Sarichef is where we're going to on this flight. And let me get the airport air nav out there so I know what's going on. And not much. There's no IFR. And there's no there's elevations of 291 feet when we get there. So that's all we have on that information. So let's go ahead and fly. I see that when I hit here, I got my full screen for flying level, and then I got my map here. Also, I have my map on here with the direction of where I'm supposed to go. Looks like there's that truck just left, and I see what I have here. I don't know why they make me go to each land, each island, and then here. Why not I just fly straight across? Okay, I'm gonna go at 3,000 feet and fly there. It should, let me see something here. I'm going to open up a folder that have some stuff in it for me. And looks like, looks like we're gonna have a flight condition. It's going to be a duration of about 27 minutes or half an hour. That's what I'm looking for. Let's go ahead and close this screen here. You probably can't see the screen, but that's okay. Let's go ahead and get outside airplane. Get my flaps back up straight. And looks like my trim tab is a little low, as you can see here, so I'm going to center it. There. And we're good to go. Let's see what it says here. POA Island. POA Island. Abatnak. Depart from Akukan Airport and head east across the plain. As you pass over the water of Trident Bay, make your way toward POA Island in the distance. And that takes about a minute and 39 seconds. POA Island. One of these islands is POA Island. Let me see if I can find that map. Okay, here it is. Up too close. I don't see POA Island. I don't see the name. I see a lot of islands out here. I don't see one that's called POA. No POA Island. I'm sure it's out there, I just don't know where to look. Okay, that's all fine. That's fine. POA Island is fine. Alright, let me go ahead and continue. From POA Island, adjust slightly southeast across Abatnak. Straight ahead lies the larger landmass, Abatnak Island. Look for a cove with a curved back ridge near a series of inland lakes and head for the bay. Let me see something here. I'm going straight across. I think I'll do that. I'll go more or less up to here. Goes from here straight to here, and then make a northerly heading to PAC. P ICS, which is the what is it called? Cape Sarichef. All right, let me get back inside the airplane. Let's get started here. Let's go and get to the runway. Alrighty, let me go outside the airplane so I can see better. I looked at a YouTube that has instructions on what each function of these control knobs on the dashboard mean and how to use it, and it's very informative, so I have a small understanding of how to use those instruments. As we progress in these legs, I get to learn more. Let's get it up there. Alrighty. Now we're up in the air. Let's get back into the cockpit. Oh, I am. Let me fix the camera a little bit. There we go. And it says I'm flying straight ahead. And what I need to do here. Okay. I'm going to go beyond these islands. I'm beyond this island. See how I just learned how to use this. I didn't know I could do that before. But a little bit small crash course, I'm able to understand what needs to be done here. Okay, so that's what we're going to do. We're going to go straight this way and then head northeast from there. Okay, let me click here. And alrighty. Let me go outside. Perfect. Alrighty. Let me close this. Oh, let me start the stopwatch. Now I'm going to use this stopwatch for my time to the duration of this leg. I'm not going to use it to measure from point A to point B, then from point B to point C, how many minutes and seconds it takes to get to each point. So I'll leave that alone. I've got the timer, and that's all I need. Got that kind of training when I lost my nav log from my last trip, my last exercise that I'd done when I was in the Adriatic Sea. Okay, let me see. So far, so good. Let me take a look here. Oops, let me take this one. Alrighty. Here I puts there, I'm here. As soon as I clear enough ways, I'll go ahead and set the autopilot. It says 300, let's make it, well, this is not where I need to do this. The selection, I'll do this one, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and make it 2,000. 500. Because I'm in the water, so it should be okay to go that low. Okay. And 2,500. And I hit the altitude button. I hit the automatic pilot. Let me hit the heading here. And hit the automatic pilot. And hit the heading button, and I think that's it. Yes, 3,500. Wonder why it does that. I said 2,500, and it came. It's now saying 3,300. No matter. I'll go ahead and fix it. There. And I hit the... There you go. Alright. I gotta turn left quite a bit. Let me hit, turn the headings here. And go northeast. There. I was going the wrong direction. But I got it fixed. I'm not gonna follow this path. It looks like a waste of time. Unless I wanted to enjoy the scenery. I'll do that. From a distance, how's that? Maybe I missed something. That's probably why it wants me to use those islands. I could use my drone to look out there. And let's go over there. Airplane. I lost my airplane. All I have to do is hit my magic button. I can just go like that. There I am. And let's do this again. That's sick. Okay, now I'm going forward. Nothing much to see here, just a few islands, that's it. And I don't see too much of anything here. Not even buildings. Just a bunch of stray islands here. Go down further. I'm hitting the drone's down button, so the drone is going down even though it's not noticeable. Nothing to see here. Nothing to see. Wow, look at that up there. Okay, let's get back to the airplane. Hitting the number 5 on the numbers keyboard. And I'm back to the airplane. And let me get inside the airplane. Let me go a little bit north. Again, it says 3,400. I don't know why it does that. Let me fix this again. 3,500. Turn off and turn back on. Here. 3,400 again. Why? 500. Let's try again. Turn off and turn on. Oh, I see. I see. This is just, alright, I understand, this is just, when I hit that, it gives me my current altitude and keeps it there. Turn FLC, oh, damn, that's what I have to hit, that button. So let me turn this off, go back to 500, and turn this on. Now I'm going up, there you go. See, I have a crash course, but I don't have a full understanding, but I'm getting there. Let's strobe light and the nav light, landing light. I don't need the landing lights in the daytime. That's fine. Everything else looks good. Okay. This is flashing red, so let me fix that problem. There. I'll keep it at about 27. That's still too high. Let's go 26 then. RPM is high, I don't understand. Let me fix this, maybe it's right here. There you go. There, much better. Let's rev this up a little bit more. All right, this is more like learning my instruments here than anything else. Have a person named SVS93. He's probably doing the same thing. Maybe he's maybe a leg or two ahead of me. I don't know. It is leg two, so I guess I didn't mention that in the beginning. Distance is 52 POI. That's where we're coming from, right? Well, we are going to PACS. Okay, this is a totally different place. This is the waypoint for POI is the waypoint. Let me see if I can see that here somewhere. No, I don't see it. Let's go look outside for a minute and see what surroundings I have. Why is it blurry like that there? Is that the water? Water? Probably. Yeah, it must be the water doing that. Kind of eerie looking. Let's go outside the airplane for a second. Take a look at the airplane, make sure I don't have any flaws. I can't move my airplane. There, now I can do it. I think, yeah, there you go. I don't see anything wrong with the airplane. Looks brand new, and I found out that it is. Brand new airplane just came out of the factory this way. I mean, it's a new model just introduced in the year 2020. Let me go back in, make sure everything's okay, and everything is okay. I just stay at this heading and at this altitude. I should be okay when I get there. Just to connect the autopilot, it's right here in the joystick and my trim. But just, it doesn't show. Let me go over here and take a look that way. It doesn't do anything. When I point to it, black and white, if I point here, it tells me what it is and how to turn it. This doesn't show. I'm sure that works. Let me see something. Now let's see. Nothing. My rudder and brakes. See the fuel. I only have the left tank working. And then when I run out of the left tank, I'll use the right tank. And if I look up here, there's my fuel indicator. On the other side should be full. And it is. What I'm going to do is to make sure my wings are level. If you have one wing heavier than one side of the wing heavier than the other side of the wing, I should say left and right. If my left is lighter than right wing, it's possible to keep. It'll be more harder to keep the plane level. It'll be tending to want to turn right, and if the tank is less and lighter on the left, lighter on the right, then it tends to make the plane turn left. Alright. Oh, what's this? Let me fix this right now. There you go. So far, so good. Almost close to this island here. That island is the Unimac Island. We are heading for Cape Sarichef. Cape Sarichef. My goodness, I just found out that mountain there. Come on. There. This here is a volcano. And I just found out by looking at the other map. And the volcano is Shishaldin Volcano. The airport we're going to is this Cape Sarichef. It has walruses. I guess the site of walruses would be there. I can't get closer with that map to take a closer look, but look it up on YouTube and get some information about that area. Alrighty. So far, so good. Let me do that, do this, get closer up the wrong one, this one. Okay, let me turn left and continue with the flight. I'm going to go descend lower. Okay, I'm going to go straight north. Oops, a little too far north. There you go. Okay. And now I'm going to descend. Let me make it 1,000 feet. Okay, I'm at 1,000 feet. Well, I'm going to set it for 1,000 feet. Let me hit the FLC and bring down the RPM. I should be dropping down to 1,000 feet. at the airport. Let me bring it up to the wrong one. This one. Still gotta get used to these controls. I'm gonna use the heading of north to land on that runway. I still don't see it. This is giving me concern, so what I'm going to do is set this for 1,500. Let me go back up. Hit DFLC. And go up. Now let's see if I can find the island. I mean the runway. Not yet. Let me get this open up. The wrong one. This one here. Should be right. All right there, the coast at the end. Still climbing to 1,500. Didn't like the way the terrain looked, so to be safe, I decided to go from 1,000 to 1,500. Maybe turn left a little bit. And let me slow down a little bit. Let me make sure that I'm going the right way by up to one. All right, I'm going the right way. Always trying to remain at least 1,000 feet above ground level, just to make sure. Still don't see anything. I don't see any airport. But I'm getting really close. Ah, there's the airport. I see it right there. We take control of the airplane and let's go. Let's bring the RPM down. I'm in the white area, the white zone, as I call it, right there. That means I'm able to put flaps. And I got the first flaps, and there's only two flaps on here, so when I get close enough, I'll go ahead and use the full flaps. Don't need this map anymore. Not the wrong one. This is what I don't need. How many minutes so far? 22 minutes. not much. I don't see any place to taxi to the airplane. I might just stay on the runway. Or maybe this is it here. Still, I might just stay on the runway. Okay, I'm gonna go out full flaps now. I'm at full flaps and I'm still descending.
500.
I know that. If I see other airplanes around, I'll park where the planes are. If I don't see anything, I'll stay on the runway. Okay, there's a place to taxi here. I can see that. Okay, I'm going too high. Let me go slowly. I'm at idle. My RPM is at idle. Nothing out here. Nothing at all. Oops, I don't want to go there. Oh, there's an airplane over there. Let me see if I can bring my flaps back up and see if I can turn around to that place. It's hard to control this plane on the ground. That it's a very large airplane. What's a plane like that doing in a small little airfield like this? Where'd the plane go? Maybe it's on the other one. Airplane disappeared. I saw it. Don't see it anymore. That's fine, I'll stay on the runway. Actually, I'll go here. See if I can turn around here. Slowly but surely. I know I'm wasting a little time here, but that's okay. Okay, let's stop right here. And it's not taking it. Gotta stay on the runway. Like I'm going up the hill. Okay, you want me to stay on the runway? I'll stay on the runway. Okay, I'll stop here. Alright, show it to me. Yes, done. More or less like 30 minutes, but 36 minutes, okay. Alrighty, this is it. I'll go ahead and go to the next leg, and I'll see you there. Bye-bye.